εις το όνομα της δυνάμεως που συνέχει τους κόσμους, μνημοσύνην καλό. Να κινήσει τον πόθο της αληθείας σε καρδιές και σε νόες, να λάμψουν οι μεγάλες ουσίες. Φως ισχύων ηλίου Κυρίου ελευθερίωνος, να αναλώσει την πλάνη, να καταδείξει, αδελφοί λαοί και τα πνεύματα όλα της γιας μητέρας, ιερά σε τόπον φωτός. Κατά νόμον του ενός, μνημοσύνην καλό, γίνομαι φως, και το φως, φως επικαλείται, φως συνάγει, φως διαχέει, φως οικοδομεί. Αλήθεια, αγάπη, δικαιοσύνη. Το φως, φως επικαλείται, φως συνάγει, φως διαχέει, φως οικοδομεί. Αλήθεια, αγάπη, δικαιοσύνη. Ήθε με αλήθεια, αγάπη, δικαιοσύνη, ειρηνικά να πορευόμαστε όλοι οι άνθρωποι και όλοι οι λαοί.
I'm very glad to be here, and that on this very special, unique day, namely 21st of June, which is the longest day of the year, the brightest day of the year as well. And it is a day on which the ancients celebrated Apollo as a light bringer. And thank you, Paris, for having recited Pindar and his evocation for Apollo. And I think it's a proper thing to do here, because it is really a kind of sacred place where we are standing. And I would also like to honor and celebrate Apollo today as a Phoebus. Apollo, you were talking about him. Phoebus would mean the bright one, the shining one, the brilliant one. This is the quality of Apollo, however. He's Phoebus. And this is the right day to honor Apollo as a Phoebus, as the bright one, as the shining one. And of course, the name is also part of his lineage, because his grandmother was called Phoebe, as you probably know. Phoebe was a Titan. And she and Chaos, another Titan, or Chios, perhaps it is pronounced nowadays, they were the parents of Leto. And Leto is the mother who gave birth to Apollo and Artemis. And so in direct lineage, Apollo is, let's say, the grandson of Phoebe, who was the goddess of the moon. Also a shining, brilliant, silvery, divine ancestor of Apollo. So today on 21st of June, we will bring our reverence to Apollo, the Phoebus, the bright one, as who he was also honored and celebrated down there in Delphi for centuries and centuries and even millennia. So I brought the English translation of the poem by Rilke. And it goes like this. Archaic torso of Apollo. We cannot know his legendary head. We cannot know his legendary head. With eyes like ripening fruit. We cannot know his legendary head with eyes like ripening fruit. And yet his torso is still suffused with brilliance from inside. With brilliance, Phoebus, with brilliance from inside, like a lamp in which his gaze, now turned to low, gleams still in all its power. Like a lamp in which his gaze, now turned to low, gleams in all its power. Otherwise, the curved breast could not dazzle you so, nor could a smile run through the placid hips and thighs to the dark center where procreation flared. Otherwise, this stone would seem defaced beneath the translucent cascade of the shoulders and would not glisten like a wild beast's fur, would not, from all the borders of itself, burst like a star, would not, like all the borders of itself, burst like a star, for, and now here comes the final climax, for here is no place, no place that does not see you. And then the final lines, you must change your life. This is a message of the torso of Apollo. And when we evoke his spirit to become part of our spirituality and of our civilization and culture, because this is what we urgently need. And therefore, I would like us to remember Apollo on that 21st of June in 2021, because I think we are really in bad need of his power, his strength, and mostly of his wisdom and sovereignty. I invite you to reconnect with the Apollonian spirit. And I like this place very much because it's so close to the temple and we have this beautiful view. And therefore I thought probably it's a good place to recite a poem.
The millennia old tale tells us that the oracle at Delphi neither speaks nor conceals but indicates. We do not have a direct route by any means to truth or the future here. Yet, when we bring the fundamental question, we may not get a literal answer, but we will get a spiritual answer, even if we totally misunderstand. And over time, it will answer the query. Are we pilgrims? Persons in motion? Passing through territories not our own. Plato believed the soul was that which moves. Here, do we seek completion, clarity, a goal to which only the spirit's compass points the way? They say we must approach the oracle with a kind of emotional and intellectual integrity, and even be humbled before the oracle. Yet, be ready for any potential greatness or fall that it might speak to us. Are we to consider it with a kind of detached reflexiveness? We recall what Theognis said, that the only way to interpret your message is like a carpenter with square and measure and rule. Aware that if we add one word, we are lost, and if we take away, we will find there is no escaping the guilt in the God's eyes.
To hear from the Delphic maxims, but permit me before to go to the maxims to give you a view what is Delphi. At the beginning, Delphi belongs to Gaia, matriarchy. Then Apollo came, killed the Python, and was a fight between matriarchy and patriarchy. And later came the Symphonia των Delphών, the Agreement of Delphi. And will you permit me to show that in a statue which we did it 91. So this is Delphi. Delphi comes from Delphis, the matrix. And this is a matrix, this is Delphi. Delphi is in plural, O-Y. It's not So here the two sexes, male and female, are equal brothers and sisters. So this is Delphi, the matrix, the two sexes, and the harmony. The seven wise men, they placed here in Delphi their 147 maxims. And coming back to the statue of Delphi, Delphi is what? Is the navel of the earth, is the synepraxis, the harmony between Dionysus and Apollo, is the oracle, the Pythian Delphi Games, and the Amphictyony link, where people were discussing for peace and cooperation. And here, for sure, the seven wise men posted their maxims. The maxims were in Laconism, very short, two or three words. You very well know thyself, that's why you have been here and back, and I will try to attract you, offering you one to each one, so you can after make your research and find your answers. So, this is the Delphi Maxims that the Delphi Union is making from time to time. This one was for the last Delphi Economic Forum. And here we give one of our messages. And the message here says, Pythian Avioste, revive the Pythian Games.
Municipality of Delphi. Nice to meet you, all of you. It's the first time, I think, for me to have this conversation with all of you. Τα υπόλοιπα θα μου επιτρέψετε να πω στα ελληνικά, δεν είναι και τόσο πολύ καλά τα ελληνικά μου. Αν μπορεί κάποιος να τα μεταφράσει και οι υπόλοιποι για να έχουν μια εικόνα και να αποτυπώνουν. Θεωρώ μια ιδιαίτερη κίνηση αυτή την οποία έχετε ξεκινήσει και τους στόχους τους κοινούς που έχετε.
Actually, a very unique movement, the approach that, and the vision that we're going to have like a team.
Και επειδή συνάδει με τους προσανατολισμούς του Δήμου μας, θα θέλαμε κι εμείς να μας ανοίξετε τα χαρτιά σας και να μπορέσουμε κι εμείς να κατανοήσουμε πού στοχεύετε και να δούμε κι εμείς πώς μπορούμε να είμαστε αλληλεί σε αυτό το οποίο στοχεύετε.
First of all, he's very delighted and very happy that everybody's here tonight. And he would like to know, let's say, with open cards, the vision, the plans, etc., so that he can also contribute to this, because they want to share the same vision, to make something for Greece, to make something for Delphi.
I would beseech that we can come from a place, certainly that dwells here, on a very exalted level of the divine law, and that we come together with openness, and we respect human law, and also the laws of nature that really coincide here and come together with such power that this does so enhance what it always was, what it always is now, no matter COVID or the like, and what it shall be even to a greater extent in the future. And keeping that holy sense of law with holy desire that also has a realistic footing, like the Sphinx, and really digging in there, but with wings to all things, as Plato requires.
I agree and I concur with everything that's been mentioned so far. At this point, from the perspective of research and resources, maybe what I'd like to say, I don't need to repeat the ideals and the potential and the energies, but what perhaps I would like to stand on is that there is an educational component, but an educational component and layer that is part of the fabric part of what we are composing at this point. And I think I'm interested in, like from the perspective of the Center for Hellenic Studies, which is where most of my professional experience is, I'm very interested in what is this educational side, this research side, and how that can be structured and taken shape.
Ήρθατε στον Ιερό Χώρο των Δελφών στο πολύ ενδιαφέρον αυτό παγκόσμιο συνέδριο της αναβίωσης του Δελφικού Ιδεώδους. Πρωτοβουλία του Προέδρου της Οικουμενικής Δελφικής Ένωσης, του κ. Παναγιώτη Καλσίνη.
Καλησπέρα. Φαίνω τους χαιρετισμούς και τα συγχαρητήρια για την πρωτοβουλία του Περιφερειάρχη Αττικής, του Γιώργου Πατούλη. Και θέλω να σας πω κάτι που δεν είναι καθόλου αυτονόητο. Είναι ένας περιφερειάρχης και ένας άντρας της τοπικής αυτοδιοίκησης που ξέρει ότι ο πολιτισμός είναι η βιομηχανία μας. Ο πολιτισμός και ο τουρισμός. Και αυτό το κάνει πράξη στηρίζοντάς μας και οικονομικά. Γιατί ο πολιτισμός είναι κάτι πάρα πολύ expensive. Λοιπόν, να το πω ελληνικά. Σε αυτό το χώρο, σε αυτόν τον τόπο, το μαγικό, έχω έρθει πολλές φορές και έχω την τιμή να παίξω και στο Θεφρίνιχο και, και στις γύρω περιοχές, όχι μόνο στους Δελφούς. Χαίρομαι ιδιαίτερα που είμαι μπροστά στο σπίτι του Σκελανού, γιατί πριν από 3 χρόνια είχα σαρκώσει την Εύα Πάλμερ στο Μουσείο Σκελανού στη Λευκάδα. Και ήθελα πάρα πολύ να γίνει γι' αυτό και εδώ, δηλαδή κάποια στιγμή να παίξω και εδώ. Όχι την Εύα Πάλμερ, οτιδήποτε, γιατί είναι υπέροχη αυτή η σκηνή, μικρή σκηνημένη, αλλά πολύ ωραία για μονολόγους ειδικά. Θέλω να σας πω ότι η πρώτη φορά που ήρθα στους Δελφούς ήταν όταν ήμουν 14 χρονών με το σχολείο μου, το Pierce College. Και αισθάνθηκα κάποια πράγματα τα οποία στα χρόνια, έχει περάσει αιώνας από τότε, με εκφράζουν απόλυτα. Είναι τα ίδια. Και αυτή η πρώτη μου συλλογή είχα την τύχη και την τιμή, μεγάλη τιμή, έτσι γι' αυτό συνέχισα να γράφω, να την εκδώσει ο Μενέλαος Λουντέμις. Στους Δελφούς. Σκεφτείτε ότι ήμουν 14 χρονών, να είστε επίγης. Πέρασαν χρόνια που μας άφησαν τα σχελετωμένα χέρια τους οι μουσες των προγόνων. Στο βάραθρο το ιερό στείλωσε τα μάτια του ο ενίοχος. Η πίκρα της περηφάνειας του έγινε δάκρυ στα μάτια του περαστικού. Αντιπρόσωπος μιας εποχής αλυσμόνητης, μαχαμένης. Πάνω σε λόφο απότομο κτίστηκε το παλάτι του ήλιου. Και ένα τραγούδι, απίστευτο τραγούδι συμπιθία στον τελευταίο πιστό βασιλιά της. Οι ώρες δεν ακούγονται στις κερκίδες αυτές. Το θέατρο, χωρίς τραγωδούς, κραυγάζει τις αλήθειες των δημιουργών του. Αντυχεί το πέρασμα του αετού στο λασπωμένο στάδιο και αναπνοή κάποιου παιδιού που αποκοιμήθηκε προσμένοντας μάταια μια καινούργια φικτιονία. Αναρωτιέμαι τι κράτησε η ψυχή μου από τους Δελφούς. Το φεγγάρι, την πηγή, το βλέμμα του χαλκού, το κυπαρίσι ή τον αητό του βράχου. Μα έγιναν ένα όλα αυτά και χάραξαν το δρόμο στις πέτρες που ανέβηκα στον πόθο μου να φτάσω. Ευχαριστώ πολύ για την πρόσκληση και ευχαριστώ για την τιμή που μου κάνατε να με εντάξετε σαν μέλος σας, σαν επίτιμο μέλος σας. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ.
why we are here is that we find the inspiration through the Delphic idea of the Apollonian spirit, where we seek healing and peace, rising culture, that is rooted in this place. Art rises because there are specific and very unique places in the world. And Delphi is that unique place, the center, the navel of the world, where the Apollonian spirit of healing, the commitment and dedication and love for the environment takes a part, so that we can revitalize those ideas through friendships, to collaboration, rooted in the community of Delphi, rooted across the world, and that we can bring these ideals together through our cultural work in a very peaceful manner. And everything merges to this idea, and then at some point it settles down in a holistic way of life. And I think Delphi has a great chance to become the role model in the world for this holistic idea. You know, being here on the side and working through the experience, I think that is something we share, and it's again because of this place. We didn't created that kind of artwork if we didn't come here as artists in residence, and that's also why it's very important, you know, to root ourselves in that place where art can emerge, because of this place. And then, of course, we have Iris Brosch, a very famous and accomplished photographer and performance artist. He is also very much interested in collaborating with people, you know, to work with her on performances and photography. And still we worked in very small group with models, and especially she likes the idea not to work with professional models, but with women and men from...
When I came with a very open mind and a very open heart, because I wanted to just experience not only the place but the people, and build relationships. And so the whole week, it was there was a lot of verbal communication, but I don't speak too much Greek. Luckily, we have many people who speak different languages, but a lot of the communication is nonverbal too. You get a sense of how somebody is, and you get a sense of the energy. And so so I could soak that up. And the piece here that I did came about completely out of my experience of being here. You mentioned technology, but I intentionally only brought a small box of a few simple tools, and I said to myself, whatever I find there, I will create something in response to what I experience. And so I told you earlier, the materials, it was a metamorphosis really of materials, because I took a simple garden irrigation hose that you wouldn't think of anything, that it's just ugly, maybe it's not even beautiful, but yet I could transform them.
I want to say that being here has been very meaningful, very, very strong experience, not only with us as friends and artists, but with you people, local people, a kind of real collaboration, a possibility to say a lot in a specific place like Delphi, which is a very magical site, specific. I mean, it is a specific site that speaks to the world, really, in a very, not only spiritual, but speaks about democracy, speaks about so many issues so important to the world nowadays. We now understand and value so many more things, and everything is vulnerable and changes, and we need to make the most out of what we do have. And so the values that are coming from Delphi, of course, revisited in a contemporary way, need to be expressed and shown to the world.
Thank you. her method in the museum. And Greek art spans from thousands of years, and we have many different styles of Greek art. What we're doing through the Greek art is looking for the clues that we have lost. So our search in the Ruby Tuna method is actually researching and searching for the missing links in ancient Greek dance itself. So it goes into other areas. I'll show you first. It's quite a very static teaching in the beginning until we get the geometry of the lines, the eight positions of offering that Jenna has found in the statues. One hand before the other. This could be holding a sheaf of wheat, flowers, a papyrus with a poem written on it. And we dedicate this to Apollo. It's it's a position of offering which we bring to Apollo's altar. So we do the first offering position with a walk, the second offering position with a walk here, the third is the big basket, and the fourth is a little bowl. The fifth is the spear and the bowl, the sixth is the little kylax on the head, the seventh is the lepithos on the shoulder, and the eighth is a big. We take the arsi. Arsi is the lift before the fall. And everything works on this way. So arsi go up and run forward into a toss forward. Run back into the center. As we go up, spiral into a spin and step into a toss. And that can also lift you up.
From my own lineage of Greek teachers, amongst them Kula Pratsika, which danced at the Delphic Festival in the 30s. And she always said that Greece was light, rhythm, and spirit. So that is something that I kept inside of me. And one last thing. One of her students, which became famous later on, Zuzuni Kouloudi, she created a kind of Hellenic dance studying the ancient Greek drama and the movement of the dancers there. She has passed away. She was quite a strict teacher. Both Kula Pratsika and Zuzu were students of Mary Wigman Kladek, so it's a more expressionistic background, but there was always the spirit and the music and the love. I start off with a breathing and exhaling wave-like movement will follow me with the music.
Today is a myth of Callisto. Callisto was a daughter of a famous king in Peloponnesus. Goddess Artemis took her under her protection. So, first of all, we are born from the earth. In that way, we experience the first experience of separation. And we start jumps with percussion. And we use our voice with a ha.